570 BC. Nebuchadnezzar, the king of the Babylonian Empire, was the most powerful man on earth.
在公元前570年前，那个巴比伦帝国的这样的一个国王尼布甲利撒是世界上是最有权势的人。
His life was a story of success. Born to a noble father, Nebuchadnezzar was the oldest son, and he led Babylon in countless military victories until they ruled a vast part of the earth.
那尼布甲利撒这样的一个，他一生呢是一个成功的一个故事，他是他那个贵族的那个父亲的第一个儿子，然后尼布甲利撒王率领巴比伦在这个无数的军事战争中能得胜。
In 570 BC, near the end of his reign, now he walked on the roof of his palace and looked down upon the awesome city of Babylon.
在公元前570年，在接近他统治的这样的一个末期的时候，那这个国王就走到他这个皇家宫殿的这样的一个屋顶，然后就俯视着这个首都巴比伦城。
The sun was reflecting golden off of blue tiles at the Ishtar Gate, and smoke and incense were rising from majestic temples.
那金色的阳光被那个衣舍塔耳门的这样的一个蓝色的瓷砖这样反射出来，就闪闪发光。然后看到这样的一个香烟，还有那个真是从这些雄伟的这样的一个庙宇里面，那是蓝蓝的往上升。
And Nebuchadnezzar reflected with pride, "Is this not Babylon the Great, which I have built by my mighty power as the royal residence for the glory of my majesty?"
那个尼布甲利撒王他就开始心里面就骄傲，他这样宣称说：“这大巴比伦不是我用那个大能大力建为首京都，要显我威严的荣耀吗？”
But while the words were still on his lips, a voice came from heaven and said, "O King Nebuchadnezzar."
当时这话还在王口中尚未说完的时候，有声音从天上降下说：“尼布甲利撒王啊！”
It is spoken to you. The kingdom is departing from you.
有话对你说，你的国位离开你了。
And you shall be driven from among men until you learn that the Most High rules the kingdoms of the earth, and he gives them to whomever he wills.
那你必被赶出离开世人，等你知道至高者在人的国中掌权，要将国赐予谁就赐予谁。
At that moment, Nebuchadnezzar lost his mind, and he was driven from among men for 7 years.
那时候，尼布甲利撒王他就失去了理智，被赶出离开了人群，有7年之久。
Nebuchadnezzar had believed that he had produced the goodness in his life, but the Lord saw a different story.
尼布甲利撒王他是相信他的人生这一切美好是他自己创造出来的，但是呢，那是主看到的是不同的这样一个故事。We'll
come back to Nebuchadnezzar.
我们稍后会回到那个尼布甲利撒王。But
for now, good morning. Welcome to Truth Lutheran Church, and can I say Happy Thanksgiving?
那么现在，真是大家早上好，我们欢迎你们来到信义会真理堂，感恩节快乐。As
most of you probably know, this is our official Thanksgiving service. And what else is a pastor to preach on Thanksgiving but gratitude?
那你们可能知道，今天是我们的感恩节这样的一个聚会。那在感恩节，除了感恩，我们的牧师还能讲什么呢？
Thanksgiving is a time to reflect upon the goodness in your life and to show your appreciation.
那感恩节的是我们能回顾生活的这些美好，并且是表达我们感激之情的时候。But
to be honest, sometimes Thanksgiving is a little bit more complex than we realize.
那实际上有时候呢，那个感恩节比我们所想象的还要更复杂一点。True
gratitude is more than just saying thank you. True gratitude means having a thankful heart.
真正的这样的一个感激，不仅仅就说一声谢谢，但是真正的这样的一个感恩，还意味着有一颗感恩的心。You
see, it's possible, like King Nebuchadnezzar, to have a life that is filled with goodness, but not to have a grateful heart.
你看，就像那个是有时候可能就像那个尼布甲尼撒王一样，我们的这个人生里面充满了许多美好的东西，但是呢，我们却没有一颗真正感恩的心。
In fact, sometimes it seems like the more wealth that you have, the less likely you are to have a grateful heart.
那事实上，有时候呢，我们可能会有越多更美好的东西，但是我们却更缺乏一颗感恩的心。
This Thanksgiving celebration, I would like to talk about what makes a grateful heart.
在今年的这个感恩节这个庆祝活动里面，我想谈一谈是什么能够产生有一颗感恩的心。
What makes a person deeply grateful?
是什么让一个人深深的感激呢？
What makes gratitude consistent? What makes a man or woman that grateful person?
是什么能够让这个感恩真正是这样的一个持续？是什么让这个是这样的一个弟兄姊妹，但是成为一个感恩的人？
We all want a grateful heart, but if you're anything like me, sometimes you don't always feel grateful.
我们都希望有一颗感恩的心，但是如果你像我一样，有时候我们就不会那么心存感激。
And that shouldn't be the case.
那这不应该是如此。
We're doing solution preaching, and here's the big question: What makes a grateful heart?
那我们正在做这个解决方案的这样的一个讲道。那这个大问题就是。是什么原因导致一个人有一颗感恩的心？
What makes a grateful heart?
是什么能够导致一颗感恩的心？
And we're going to find the answer to that question in 1 Corinthians 15 verses 9 and 10.
我们将在哥林多前书的第十五章的九到十节呢找到这个问题的答案。
Please open your Bibles to 1 Corinthians 15 verses 9 and 10.
请打个圣经翻到哥林多前书的十五章九到十节。
And while you're turning there, please listen.
那你翻到那个地方的时候，请听。
We're going to look at a Thanksgiving moment in Paul's life this morning.
那我们在今天的这感恩节，我们看看这个使徒保罗他的这样的一个感恩的时刻。
And we're going to discover two realizations which make a grateful heart.
那我们能够找到是两个让他产生这样的一个感恩之心的这样一个认识。
Two realizations, two recognitions, two self-understandings that produce a grateful heart.
那是两个这样的一个意识，两个那个自我的认识，产生这样的一个感恩的心。
Two recognitions, and in the end, they're going to become one big idea, one answer.
有两个这样的一个意识，最终呢导致这样的成为一个这样的一个解决的方案，一个答案。
First Corinthians 15:9-10. But before we read, would you join me in prayer?
那哥林多前书十五章九到十节，在我们那个读经之前，请让我们一起来祷告。
Lord, we pray that you would open the eyes of your people.
主啊，求你呢，真是打开我们的，真是我们的眼睛。
Help us to understand.
让我们能够明白你的话。
Help us to understand a grateful heart.
让我们明白这样一颗感恩的心。
In Jesus' name we pray.
奉耶稣基督的名。
What makes a grateful heart? Two realizations.
是什么产生这个感恩的心呢？是两个这样的一个认识。
And 1 Corinthians 15, 9 and 10, Paul is reflecting on his apostleship.
那在哥林多前书的第十五章九到十节，那保罗在反思，在回顾他的这样的一个特殊的这样的一个使徒地位
，and his privileged position of being a witness of Christ's resurrection，
并且是作为基督这样复活的这样的一个见证人的地位。
In 1 Corinthians 15:6-8, Paul is making this list of people that saw Jesus after he was resurrected。
在哥林多前书十五章的六到七节，那保罗列举了，那个是在耶稣复活以后。向他们显现的这一系列的人的名单。
And Paul's at the end of the list. He says, "And finally, he appeared to me. Finally, Jesus appeared to me as to one abnormally born."
在最后，保罗提到了自己说，那个末了也显给我看，如同未到产期而生的人一般。
And follow along as you read verses 9 and 10.
那我们再读九到十节。
For I am the least of the apostles.Unworthy to be called an apostle, because I persecuted the church of God.
我原是使徒中最小的，不配称为使徒，因为我从前逼迫神的教会。
But by the grace of God, I am what I am, and his grace to me was not in vain. On the contrary, I worked harder than any of them, though it was not I, but the grace of God that was with me.
那我今日成了何等人，是蒙神的恩才成的。 并且他所赐给我的恩不是徒然的，我比众使徒格外劳苦。这原不是我，乃是神的恩与我同在。What
makes a grateful heart?
是什么能够产生一颗感恩的心呢？
If you're familiar with the story of Paul, you know that Paul had a checkered past before he became a Christian.
如果你熟悉使徒保罗的话，你知道在他成为基督徒之前，他有一个黑暗的过去。He
was born into a Jewish sect, and he grew up as this self-righteous religious leader called a Pharisee.
那他出生在一个严格的这样的一个犹太家庭，那长大以后成为一个一种那个自以为是的这样的一个法利赛人的这样的一个教派的宗教领袖。At
first, Paul persecuted the followers of Jesus. He beat them and threw them in prison and even handed some over to death.
那刚开始的时候，那保罗逼迫了这个基督的像耶稣的信徒，他殴打他们，监禁他们，甚至把一些人带入死地。
God saved him.
直到上帝拯救他。
Now, many years later, as Paul is writing these words, he reflects on this gift of being an apostle.
在多年以后，当保罗写下这些话的时候，他回顾到他是所接受的这样的一个使徒的位分。
And he recognizes that he does not deserve it.
他意识到他并不配得这一切。
Verse 9 says he doesn't even deserve to be called an apostle.
那第九节说，因他不配成为一个使徒。
He's saying, I don't deserve this position. I don't deserve to be forgiven.
他说，我不配得到这个位置，我不配能够得到这样的一个赦免。
Paul realized that he was unworthy of the great goodness in his life, and that realization that he was unworthy made him so grateful.
那保罗意识到他不配得到他人生中这些美好的东西。 正是因为认识到这种不配，使他真是心中感激不尽，有一颗感恩的心。
When you think about it, you aren't really grateful for the things that you deserve, are you?
你想想看，你是不是对于人生里面这些东西，你真的是不配的？
You aren't really thankful when you treat someone kindly and they treat you kindly in return. You expect that.
那当你善待别人，别人也善待你的时候，你不会真正心存感激的，因为你觉得这应该配得的。
But you feel particularly thankful when you get angry and lose your temper and you're rude to someone and then they treat you kindly in return.
但是当你又发脾气又粗鲁地对待别人，而别人这样的很仍然真善待你的时候，
You're not particularly thankful when your mother makes you dinner, but when you go to your friend's house and your friend's mother feeds you like you're her own son or daughter, then you're particularly grateful.
当你妈妈给你做饭的时候，你不会特别心存感激，你觉得是应当的。但是，当你去一个朋友的家里，那他朋友的妈妈是又给你做饭，又给你真是善待你，就把你当做他的亲生的儿子一样，这时候你肯定会心存感激。We're
most grateful when we get more than what we're worth.
当你得到你所配超过你所配得的时候，你会心存感激的。What
makes a grateful heart? You begin to gain a grateful heart when you realize that you are unworthy.
那是什么产生一个感恩的心呢？是当你意识到恩是你所得的超过你所配得的时候，你就开始心里面感激。That
the goodness in your life is more than you deserve.
那你意识到你生命里面这些美好的东西超过你所配得。Truly,
we are all unworthy.
但实际上我们真正的是都不是真正配得的。The
Bible says that we are all sinners, that we have broken the laws of God.
圣经里面说，我们都是罪人，我们都触犯了神的律法。In
the just eyes of God, we all deserve immediate punishment. We're really like criminals according to God's law.
在神的眼中，我们得到的是应该是立即这样的一个惩罚。我们都在神的法律律法中，我们都是罪犯。Does
a criminal deserve a beautiful home in Naperville, or a loving family, or a new Lexus?
一个这样的一个罪犯配得在这个在雷普维尔这么一个很美好的家庭，或者是一个大学的教育，或者是一个那个Lexus这样的一个车辆吗？
The only goodness that a criminal to God's law deserves is punishment.
那真正这个罪犯是在神的律法中所配得的，应该是这样的一个惩罚。
Not only are we under God's conviction, but also think about the people around you.
我们不仅仅是在神的这个律法面前是被定罪的，你想想周围的人。
Don't you think there's someone out there who is more worthy than you are of your position?
那是不是周围有其他的人比你的更胜任、更配的你现在的这个职位？
Maybe some poor, unfortunate man or woman who would use the gifts that you've been given better than you would.
那或许是其他的这些周围的一些人，他们可以就是使用你现在所有的这样的恩赐，而且是更好的使用。
When we really look deeply at the goodness in our lives, we should all be able to say with Paul, "I don't deserve this."
当我们真正能够审视到我们生命里面这些美好的东西的时候，我们应该也像保罗这样说：“我们不配的这一切。”
I am unworthy.
我不配得的这一切。
And when you recognize that you are unworthy, boom, 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 a grateful heart begins to beat.
当你真正认识到你的这样的一个不配的时候，那你的心里面就开始蹦蹦跳动，你就心里面真正就产生了一个感恩的心。
What makes a grateful heart? One, you have to recognize that you're unworthy.
是什么产生一个感恩的心呢？第一个，你必须认识到你自己的不配。
Paul continues in verse 10.
那保罗在第十节继续说。
But by the grace of God, I am what I am, and His grace towards me was not in vain. On the contrary, I worked harder than any of them, though it was not I, it was the grace of God that was in me.
并且他所赐给我的恩不是徒然的，我比众使徒格外劳苦，这原不是我，乃是神的恩与我同在。
Paul realized not only that he was unworthy, but he also realized that the goodness in his life was received, not achieved.
那保罗不仅仅是认识到他不配，而且他更进一步认识到他真正人生里面这些美好的东西不是靠努力奋斗得来的，而是靠接受的。
In Malcolm Gladwell's 2008 book, Outliers, he discusses an interesting phenomenon in Canadian ice hockey.
在一个 Malcolm 那个 Gladwell 在2008年所写的一个书叫做那个异常值里面，他考察了这种加拿大这个冰球的一个有趣的现象。
One night in the 1980s, there was this psychologist named Roger Barnsley, and he was sitting with his wife watching a Canadian hockey game.
在二十世纪八十年代的一个晚上，这个心理学家有个心理学家叫 Roger 那个 Barnsley。跟他的太太在一起看一场那个加拿大的这样的一个冰球比赛。
Mrs. Barnsley had a program with the list of the players and some of their information, and she was looking at the players' birthdays when she noticed something strange.
那个巴恩斯利那个夫人，她手中呢有一个关于这些冰球球员的这样的一个信息的一个节目单，她正在查看那些球员的生日，她意识到一个很有意思的现象。
She realized that almost every player on the ice was born in the first 4 months of the year, January, February, March, or April.
她发现了啊，这几乎所有的这些冰球球员，他们的生日都是在每年的这一月到四月，那个一二三四这头四个月。
Mr. Barnsley was surprised when he saw this, and he went home and looked up every Canadian hockey player he could.
那巴恩斯利对这个现象，他就感到很惊异。他就回到家里去查，就所有的这些那个冰球球员的这个生日。
And he found similarly that the vast majority of professional Canadian hockey players are born in the first 4 months of the year.
他就发现，那几乎所有的加拿大的这些冰球球员哈，他们的生日都是在每年的头四个月。
Even today, most Canadian hockey players are born in the first 4 months of the year.
那即使是到今天为止，那绝大部分那个加拿大的那个冰球球员，他们的生日也是如此。
After further research, he found out that the explanation was actually pretty simple.
他做了更进一步的这样的一个调查，发现这个现象的背后的解释其实很简单。
Canadian youth hockey leagues create levels of competition based on the year of a child's birth.
那加拿大的他们那个青年联赛哈，它是按照那个球员的出生年份来划分那个比赛的那种级别。
So all the boys born in like 2000 are one level.All the boys born in 1999 are another level. 1998 are another level.
那就是说，比如说那些所有在2001年出生的这些男孩，他们属于一个级别；在1999年出生的又是另外一个级别；1998年的另外一个级别。
So naturally, the boys born at the beginning of the year have the advantage of age.
那很自然的，就是说，那些出生在每年头几个月份的这些男孩们，他就有一个天生的优势。
If you think about it, a boy born in January of 2001 is almost a full year older than a boy born in December of 2001.
那你想一想，2001年1月份出生的一个男孩，他比那个在2001年12月份出生的一个那个男孩几乎要大了整整一岁。
And that 11-month gap makes a big difference when you're 4 or 5 years old.
那11个月份的这种年龄差别，对一个5、6岁的男孩来说，那个是差别是很大的。
So from the beginning, the older players look the best, they're the best players, then they get picked for special coaching and special teams, and over time they leave the rest in the past.
那像刚开始的时候，你知道，那些球员的早出生的这些球员，他们就有很大的这个优，他们展现了很大的优势，所以他们就会给更多的这些辅导，这些机会，那渐渐的他们就开始拉开了与同年龄其他球员的这样的一个区别。
Early birth month is a huge gift in Canadian hockey.
那这种早出生的这样的年份，在加拿大这个冰球比赛里面是一个很大的这样的一个恩赐，一个礼物。
No doubt, most professionals worked hard to achieve their place in the professional hockey league.
那毫无疑问的是，那些职业球员，他们为了成为一个职业球员，他们付出了很大的这样的努力。
But many would not be there if they had not received an early birth month.
那很多人，他们如果不是因为这种出生的年月份上这样的一个优势的话，他们很可能就达不到那个地步。
In 1 Corinthians 15:10, Paul says that he realizes that the goodness in his life was received from God, and it was not achieved; it was a gift of grace.
那在哥林多前书的15:9-10里面，保罗就说，他是这样的一个，他意识到他所得到这些美好的东西哈，他不是靠自己的努力达到的、获得的。而是靠从神那里领受的。
And the same is true for you.
那同样你也是如此。
Before you worked hard to pass that college entrance exam, you had to have the opportunity just to take the exam.
那在你在认真努力的去参加这个大学那个考试之前，在那个大学入学考试之前，你首先要有这样的机会能够参与这个考试。
Before you worked hard to come to the United States, you probably had parents.That taught you how to work hard. That supported you financially for a certain amount of time.
在你能够努力来到美国之前，那可能你的父母亲他在辅导了你，他资助了你，所以有这样的机会。
Before you had the best, before you earned the best grade in the class, you had a tutor that no one else had.
那你可能你在获得那种在这个最好的考试成绩之前，你可能有个特别的这样的一个助教，或者是来辅导你、帮助你。
The big picture of the goodness in your life is that your goodness through all these facets and factors has been received, not achieved.
从大学上看，每一个人一生这些美好的东西，它不是靠着这人的努力但是达到的，而是靠从领受而得来的。
You worked hard, Paul worked hard, but even in his hard work, Paul says the hard work was the grace of God.
那你可能很认真努力，保罗也认真的努力，但是呢，那个即使是这份那个认真努力的这样的一个能力，也是从神来领受的。
I'm going off script a little bit, but isn't Ming doing an amazing job? What makes a grateful heart? What makes a grateful heart?
是什么才能让你有个感恩的心？是什么呢？能产生这个感恩的心呢？
One, when you recognize that you're unworthy.
第一，当你认识到你不配的，你所得到这一切。
And two, when you recognize that your goodness is unachieved.
第二，是你意识到你生命里面这些美好的东西不是靠努力得来的。
You didn't make the goodness happen. It was a gift from God.
不是靠你的努力成就这件事情，而是从神而来的这样的一个礼物。
Unworthy and unachieved.
不配，也不是靠成就得来的。
When an unworthy person receives the kindness of God, it's called grace.
当一个不配的人得到一个这样就是神赐下这样美好东西的时候，那个称为恩典。
And you will have a grateful heart when you can look at your life and see it as a story of God's.
那当你 能回顾自己的那种人生，发现这样的一个人是神的恩典的给这造就了这一切的时候，你就开始会有一个感恩的心。
After 7 years of madness, King Nebuchadnezzar's mind came back to him. He regained his sanity.
那在七年之后，那个巴比伦的这个尼布甲尼撒王，他就是后来恢复了理智，他的理智。他就开始那个是回到了他的一个正常状态。
And he realized that the goodness in his life wasn't because of his great majesty, and it wasn't because of his awesome power, but he realized that the goodness in his life was a gift from God, and that he was unworthy to have received it.
那他真是他回顾他的这些成功，人生里面的这些美好，他就发现不是靠他自己的伟大这样的一个权势，他伟大的威严所造就的。而一切都是从神那里，那是赐给他的。
And when he came back to his mind, he bowed his knees and he praised the King of Heaven because he had finally gained a grateful heart.
当他意识到他这一切的时候，他就开始能跪在地上，能够赞美神。他开始有一颗感恩的心。
In closing, here's the big idea.
那这里面，这就是个总结性。
Here's the main point of the message.
那是这个。是这个讲到的主题。
If you've been sleeping through most of it, just gain this last part.
如果你一直都在打盹是吧？就明白这一点就够了。
You will gain a grateful heart when you recognize that your life is a story of God's grace.
你当你意识到你的一生是一个神的恩典的故事的时候，你心里面就会产生一个感恩的心。
Recognizing grace.
认识到恩典是创造了这样的感恩，导致了感恩。
Recognizing grace creates gratitude.
认识恩典，真的是产生了这样的感恩心。
We are so grateful.
我们是如此的这样的感恩。
That's right.
我们一起祷告。
Lord, we see your grace.
神啊，我们看见了你的恩典。
Lord, you have been so good to us.
你是如此的恩待我们。
We cannot thank you.
我们不能够更是足够的感激你。
I pray, Lord, that you would forgive us when we have looked at our lives and when we have thought that we have been self-made men and women.
我们在你面前祈求，但是求你帮助我们，但是回顾我们的一生的时候，我们看到的不是我们自己创造了这些美好。
Your goodness, your grace is our life.
你的这样的一个。是恩典是我们的这样的一个生命。
Thank you.
谢谢你。
Truly, thank you.
真正的感激你。
In Jesus' name we pray.
奉耶稣基督的名。阿门。